Praise God, brothers and sisters. This is Brother Santosh coming to you with yet another episode on Blessed Life in Christ podcast and video series. Today is a day of prosperity. And today, especially, we are going to meditate on why we should learn about prosperity. Let me tell you a story. This is something which has happened. You might have heard about Charles Spurgeon. He was a dynamic preacher in the late 18th, 19th century, I believe. And he had a congregation of more than 10,000 people. And those were the days where there is no public audio system or anything like that. And he was able to reach those thousands of people. He received a message saying one of his believers, an old lady, she was very sick and was about to die, and so he wanted to visit her. It was a pathetic little house, and when he went in there, you know, he inquired about her health. And while he was sitting there, he was taking a look around the house, and there was a beautiful document hanging on the wall. And you know, he went and took it and started reading it. After reading that document, you know, which was hanging on the wall, he came and asked this poor woman who was about to die, "Do you know anything about this?" And that lady said, "Yes, yes, brother, it was a gift given to me by my previous employer. He was a very rich person, and I served him faithfully, and he also liked me very much. And when he was about to die, that rich man gave this paper to me, and I didn't want to, you know, lose it somehow, so that is why I put it on the wall as a decorating piece." You know what that was actually? It was actually a will, a document, where she was bestowed upon a portion of his wealth, which was huge, very huge fortune during those days. Because she didn't know how to read, neither did she approach anyone what that was about, she was about to die as poor as she can be. Dearly beloved, this is exactly the situation of many a Christian these days. They have beautiful Bibles. They have all kinds of versions of the Bible. But they really don't know what is inside the Bible for them. And you know what? When Jesus Christ died on the cross, He did not die just for the sake of forgiving your sins. He also died for your diseases. Not only diseases, but also for the curses. And finally, but not, you know, last but not the least, as people say, He also died poor so that these, you and me, we can become rich. He was made poor on the cross so that we can become rich. And not many really know about that. And because they don't know that they have this kind of inheritance in the Bible, they really don't read that much. Dearly beloved, why are we learning prosperity in this series? We are learning this. There is you know, it is not, I have not chosen this topic in a haphazard manner. I have chosen this topic with very important idea, very important goal, that we should inherit all that God has promised for us on the cross. Whatever He has accomplished on the cross, we have to take it by faith. That is the idea behind this podcast and video series. Dear beloved, let me prophesy you with open eyes. You just record this date, today's date, and you, whatever amount of debt you have, you also write that down. If you continue to stay with me and learn everything that I am about to teach you on this topic of prosperity, healing, and faith, dearly beloved, you just take it from me. You cannot remain in debt for long. Yes, this is an open, this is a prophecy, and this is an open challenge to every person who is hearing this podcast or viewing this video on the YouTube. I challenge you today. All you have to do is just stay with me. Continue to stay with me. Learn every day. You know, give, my podcasts are not more than 15-20 minutes. Today I am going to finish it in just 10 or 12 minutes. And every day I am going to teach you something about the Bible, which says about prosperity, healing, and faith to get these both. Dearly beloved, it is God's will. It is God's will that you, in fact, that is one of the blessings which God promised for His children, that thou shalt not lend, thou shalt not borrow, but shall lend. Dearly beloved, I want to show you one verse and close. This is regarding Jesus Christ when He was about to start His ministry. Let us take a look at Luke 4th chapter, and we'll start from, you know, in this 4th chapter, we see Jesus Christ being taken to the wilderness, and He was tested by the devil, and He comes out victoriously, of course. And He went to His home place, that is Nazareth, and I'm reading the 16th verse, and He came to Nazareth, where He had been brought up, and as His custom was, He went into the synagogue on the Sabbath day and stood up for to read. And there was delivered unto Him the book of the prophet Isaiah, and when He had opened the book, He found the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, because He has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives, a recovering of sight to the blind, and to set them at liberty, them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord." Dearly beloved, when you are bound by debts, you should remember that you are a slave. The borrower is slave to the lender. And not only that, because of these debts, people are being pressured every side. They are broken hearted. They are captives. And because they are, you know, borrowing on a continuous basis, they are living in the land of the blind. They are blind. Because had they known the verses in the Bible, they would not remain in debt for long. Dearly beloved, Jesus Christ, one man of God, said, of all the topics Jesus Christ spoke about when he was doing his ministry, money is the subject where he spent a lot of time. And of course, we need money to survive this world. And Jesus Christ starts by saying he was sent to preach the gospel to the poor. Only those who are poor, they go and borrow, right? Not many rich borrow. So when you borrow, you become a captive to the lender. Dearly beloved, you have come to the right place. This is why we should learn about prosperity. And today's lesson, this is going to be a bit of fun. I'm going to tell you the topic of this today's message and close. The topic of the today's message is supernatural debt cancellation. If you are in debt, I tell you, in the name of the Lord, if you start following the word, and if you are going to put it on your before your eyes, believe it in your heart, confess it with your mouth, dearly beloved, you are not going to remain in debt for long. Please underline today's date. Please underline how much debt you have and start following the lessons I'll be teaching you in the coming days. Just trust in the Lord. You will be blessed. Please continue to stay with me. And if you know anyone who is in this kind of a position, please recommend them. Please share them with your friends. If you are seeing this in the Facebook or whatever social media platform, please share it with others. May God bless you, and I'll see you tomorrow.